Breaking, look what Trump just did when he found out who moved in as White House mole while he's out of town. There's a mole in the White House who's about to be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. Well, that's what the word on the streets is. If they're prosecuted is one thing. If they're found guilty is another thing. If this happens within 10 years is another story on a whole nother level. President Trump has made it very clear and concise in his warning that anyone leaking sensitive information will be busted hard. Democrats in the White House leaking info to other places that should not have certain information have set themselves up for future failure. If a Democrat ever wins the presidency again, then they should expect the same thing to happen to them. If Democrats are leaking valuable information out of the White House like water leaking out of a small crack in a water bottle, then they're harming the president and harming fellow Americans. This is how horrible the Democrats have become. They're butthurt, angry, crybabies, who need to grow up and work with the Republicans in order to bring America to an amazing place. Working against the president and the GOP only causes further divide. Obama already created a racial divide while serving as a lackluster president, so can you Democrats chill out with the nonsense and start acting like adults once in a while? Do you want to get arrested? Because that's how you get arrested. Donald Trump pledged that those in his administration who are leaking sensitive information will be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. In a statement Thursday, the president said he has asked the Department of Justice to launch a complete review into leaks, which he finds deeply troubling because they pose a grave threat to national security. These moles are so self-centered that they're willing to risk national security for their personal and party gain. It's almost June and we're many months into the 45th presidency and people won't stop crying about it. Look folks, no one really wants an orange president. However, we would take an orange businessman over a liberal Democrat crook any day of the week. If there's one thing about Trump that we like, it's that he puts US first and we don't have to worry about offending anyone. There is nothing worse on this planet than the politically correct, safe space needing, fish-faced trigglypuff meltdown liberals and crybabies. Liberals have become so mentally deficient and inept that they're no longer logical. Bring logic and facts to your arguments and check your weakling feelings at the door. These leaks have been going on for a long time and my administration will get to the bottom of this, Trump said in the statement. I am asking the Department of Justice and other relevant agencies to launch a complete review of this matter, and if appropriate, the culprit should be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. Well, here's an idea, Trump, stop everything and figure it out. Instead of pushing NATO people out of the way, in a friendly man-hug manner, you could be waterboarding a White House mole. Bring back the good old-fashioned torture and get to the bottom of this. Waterboard everyone in the White House until someone talks. Meanwhile, if you see anyone practicing waterboarding on themselves in the event that they're caught, then you may want to check in on them. Attorney General Jeff Sessions echoed Trump's outrage over leaks in a separate statement. I share the president's deep concern and talked to Home Secretary Rudd yesterday about this matter. These leaks cannot be tolerated and we will make every effort to put an end to it. We have already initiated appropriate steps to address these rampant leaks that undermine our national security. What's the point of leaking information? Why don't both parties team up and work together and make our country amazing? All the bipartisan nonsense and fighting with each other only gives the mainstream media something to talk about that further divides people and forces guys like me to call people cucks. I'd like to see some compromise and progress on teamwork. So many jobs in America force people to work as a team, but the people who run the country don't work as one. Does everyone in the White House need some teamwork training? I'd suggest a hunting trip, but we know how that turned out, right, Dick? Maybe the White House employees can do one of those girly paint nights together. Can you imagine everyone painting the Trump wall at the border of Mexico? Hilarious, rinked, rinked.